Dire
okay,
team
welcome to the Murray Cup 2016 Red Group Generic Dota 2 Team.txt versus We Kinda Suck, game 1 of 2. I'm General Jeevicus, and I'm going to be joined today in the commentary box by Kingy from Fetty Attack 786. How you doing, man?
5 seconds remaining.
Sup, bro? I'm doing good. I'm loving the banter between the teams, or more from a generic Dota team and We Kinda Suck. But, you know, we've got René Descartes, father of modern philosophy, psychology, philosophy, whichever one it is. Drafting for them, so that looks good.
Yeah, I think that was a guy that was all about the state of nature, right?
Well, he was a mathematician, I know that, but who cares? He's long dead anyway.
Those Renaissance fellows who had their finger in more than one pie. Let's see whether or not these guys of We Kinda Suck pan out. René's Beastmaster, and we'll see what else kind of pie he can handle today. But let's have a look at the first bans there. OD banned out, no real surprise there. The Wisp taken out for Coplus. That's a smart ban if you ask me. Earth Spirit and Death Prophet banned out by We Kinda Suck. First pick though for generic Dota team.txt, Lich. I do like to see Lich in the game. He's probably going to sit in the off lane and just kind of really mess up. It's going to be Paul in the safe lane, or will we see Tyree?
10 seconds remaining.
I'm just surprised there wasn't a first pick on that Invoker, considering he never got banned this game, unless they don't have Invoker players, that is.
Dire team pick.
Hang on, let me just check.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Omni Knight.
Radiant's team will play an Invoker, but generally I think he plays their support, so probably not going to see him picked up on that side. Aerofang, I think, can play Invoker. Just having a look for them. Jeebus.
Is it a flawless 8k Invoker he plays, or is it just a generic 7k Invoker?
I do believe he's at 8.5k Invoker, but there's a set of picks picked up there. Rubik for We Kinda Suck and Omni Knight, so both supports getting picked up, and I imagine Visage being played in the support role as well. I'm gonna probably think that we'll see Elliot on the Lich, maybe the Boulder on Visage.
5 seconds remaining.
I wonder, probably Coplus on the Omni Knight or Curse.
Dire team ban.
Those two guys seem fairly interchangeable. Sven banned out. Generic Dota 2 team.txt still not recovered from that
Sven
game against Team Straight. Early in the group, Beastmaster banned out by We Kinda Suck. This should be interesting to see where René
Dire
goes.
Team ban.
Like I said, I don't think we've seen him on anything but Beastmaster. Silencer banned out by Generic Dota 2 team.txt. Looks like they won't be. They don't want to be dealing with that.
I wouldn't be surprised Generic Dota team would actually pick up a Drow Ranger for their mid and maybe a Luna for their safe lane, and then a possible Wind Ranger for their off lane, going for a mega push strat with that early push.
Yeah, that sounds pretty brutal. All of the heroes ranged obviously so far. I can imagine the combination together would be pretty devastating. We did see Visage Drow Ranger played earlier in the tournament. With great effect.
Yeah, that would be my team.
Ah, I think maybe they might be trying to pick up some tips there. Morphlink, though, picked up probably for Paul in the mid there. But, I mean, a versatile hero can be the position 1, 2 mid or safe carry there. Evoker banned out by We Kinda Suck, though. I don't think that's really an issue. Errol Fangs Viper picked up for mid then, I expect, once again. I'm a bit surprised about that silencer ban, though. I mean, he has a pretty good counter to Omni Knight's all-powerful Guardian Angel.
Yeah, but what I think what they're overlooking here is I think they might want to stick that Viper in the offlane and maybe select an Invoker for mid. Oh, he's been banned out. I didn't really actually notice that. I was going to say Invoker, Tornado really counters Omni's ult, sort of making Omni useless, really, in fights. But let's see what they pick up instead.
Reserve time.
Tidehunter for Gref Radiant in the offlane then. I mean, some of these heroes we've seen We Kinda Suck play before. You're probably not quite so familiar with them. I think we've watched about four of their matches so far. So, I mean, that seems to be fairly comfortable heroes. So I like Tidehunter in the offlane. Obviously, he doesn't really need that much to get going. Arcane Boots and a Blink Dagger. And, once he does get going, great team fight potential. Also, I love the Kraken shell.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, they seem to have quite strong lanes at the moment. Obviously, they're going to go for that tri lane, I hope. Stick that Tidehunter in the solo off lane position. So they're either going to pick up a carry or a mid hero, because Morphling's one of those versatile heroes that can be played in sort of both positions.
Yeah, I mean, Cobblest does kind of like to sit behind Paul in the mid, so I'm wondering if whether or not if the Rubik might be sitting around there and just kind of harass the hell out of Errol Fang. I don't know, though. I think the tri lane is obviously a definite possibility, probably more likely to be that, but I wouldn't be surprised to see him there. But, Timbersaw picked up for the off lane. Well, that'll be Rene, then, I expect, that's going to go on that hero. Yeah, like I say, he does seem to be a bit of an offlane specialist. I don't know, he does an awful lot with it. Almost single-handedly carrying the team to victory in all their games so far.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I've noticed his Beastmaster is really strong. I think it was... I'm not sure what game it was, but I did notice he picked up a 15-minute Necro 3 at one point on the offlane, which was absolutely crazy for the timing. Took either Tier 1, pushed in their Tier 2s, was sort of getting a bit out of control. It was just unfortunate that they lost momentum with that push ability.
Yeah, absolutely. Pipped at the post so many times. I kind of feel bad for him really sometimes, because he is obviously playing his heart out, and they just can't get the game finished before 40 minutes, and their builds kind of tend to taper off around then.
5 seconds
Beastmaster
remaining.
Not able to solo carry the game beyond that point, really. A Phantom Lancer, though, banned out by We Kinda Suck. And finally, a Windranger ban for Genetic
Team.txt.
Interesting ban for the Windranger, but then, like I say, the Morphling is, it could be mid, it could be safe lane. So, I mean, just kind of covering their bases there. And Windranger's pretty good in pretty much any lane, I think.
I'd quite like to see Ember Spirit come out for their safe lane on We Kinda Suck. I think that would work quite well with a sort of team fighting ability that they seem to have got, especially the Tidehunter and his Ravage. That was Searing Change, and Slate of Fist can do a lot of damage.
Medusa. So I mean, pretty heavy on the farm for Dire. I presume Rubik's going to have to play a fairly hard 5 here. Obviously, Omni does need a little bit of farm. Lone Druid, that could be for Rennie as well, but where the hell would you put Timbersaw? This is a total change of positions here. They're totally shaking things up. Elliot on the mid. And tonight's victim of the Lux server disconnections will in fact be General Jeevicus. That's awesome. As I was saying, Rennie is going to pick up the Visage. Elliot is going on to the Viper. Errol Fang on the Lone Druid. Finn Death on the... Is he on the Timber? I can't quite see what heck's going on here at the moment. Let's have a look.
Yeah, he's on the Timber.
He's on the Timber and the Boulder on the Lich. So that's like a total change of roles for the team here. Just wonder if they're shaking things up after those defeats, seeing if maybe trying out some people in different lanes, or maybe more on heroes that people are specialists in. I don't know. This is a different team we're looking at here. From Genetic, go to team.txt. We'll see how they start their lanes, though. That might kind of settle things for us. Hang on.
Picked up a smoke on that Rubick, so they might be going for that early five-man push. Well, gank, sorry. Try and pick one of them off early game, get that first blood.
Yeah, the we kind of suck like to do a wraparound tactic with their smoke in the early, for the first rune there. But they're not really playing for it just now. Normally they would have gone down bottom via, near the Roche pit there. But they're going to try for the top rune, it seems. They do like to have a five-man swap, though, I have to say.
30 seconds to battle.
I just wonder what their laning's going to be.
Yeah, I'm curious to see whether or not they put the Medusa mid. No smokes for Generic. No mangoes either, I have to say.
I really do hope that the Medusa goes for an early game push build, because I think with their team, once everyone's got six, they can pretty much demolish them in team fights.
It does look like she's heading mid though, so we'll probably see that sort of setup. No action then for the early runes, and we have Elliot sitting here with the boulder in behind. Is he gonna rotate?
If that Rubick had on the top lane, if the Rubick had been a bit pushed up with the Omni Knight when harassing that Timbersaw, I think they could have got the first blood then and there. But the Timbersaw's just been zoned out by that Omni with his right click.
Yeah, we got a nice lane ward there as well, which is going to give them vision of Finn Death. Finn Death is normally the safe lane carry as well, I think. I have seen him in the off lane before. Did we see him in the off lane? Or was he in mid before at one point? Played Wraith King, etc. before. Fifty ping is good, man.
I thank you.
What do you think Finn Death's going to have to do here then? Maybe try and sort of set up some sort of stacks in the on the hard camp there? I mean, how does he even deal with that? He doesn't really have much. I suppose you could chain around it a little bit, I guess, and do some pure damage, but...
I think the Lich should come off lane, to be honest, and help him out. He's just going to be wasted in that bottom lane. Because to be honest, it could actually spare the Visage top as well. Lone Druid's really effective of solo laning, so even versus this Tide, I think he can still win his lane. So I think the two supports would be better served in the top lane.
Yep, go offensive tri lane. Maybe have the Lich denying creeps to the Morphling. I don't have a problem with that. And then obviously having Visage there just to harass the Omni out. Obviously much more potent once he gets to level 6. As far as harass goes with the birds there, probably D-Gen Aura picked up yet on Coplis.
You knew I was cold-blooded.
Because at the moment, this Finn Death's had not a single piece of XP, and it's 2 minutes into the game now. which is a really bad position to be.
Yeah, the boulder's coming top to try and help things out a bit. That's a good move, I think. That's a good move, I think. We can see as well that down here in the bottom lane, Edelfang doing okay for farm as far as the Lone Druid goes. Warfling though, ahead. Look at the 13 denies, almost as many denies as last hits here. Paul really showing his chops, able to switch, as we see, like I say, with the top tier teams, able to switch between mid and off lane, safe lane.
Mission's taken away.
Yeah, he's holding lane equilibrium really well. He's sort of messed it up a wee bit now. I think he got a bit distracted while he went over to the secret shop. Just to finish off his Aquila, but they've got a 3 stack at the moment as well for him to take once he's got that level 7 and 4 points in his waveform.
Yeah, that'll give him a bit of a farm boost and probably get him up to that level, a level 8, 8.5 sort of area, I would think. This is much better, I think, on the boulder here. Can of course sacrifice catapults now, which is nice, with the change, with the magic change. Oh, they found the stack, so they're going to be aware that that's there, but they're going to pay for that little bit of information with First Blood, Paul picking up with the waveform in there.
I don't like Paul's early point in Adaptive Strike though. I don't think it's really needed at the moment. Yeah, I think it's just sort of a waste of his mana. It doesn't really put out enough damage for him.
I think it's probably just a value point though. I don't think he's going to be... I think it's just there just in case he needs it. It does offer a stun, right? An interrupt.
Yeah, it depends. Depends if he's more strength or agility. Agility is more of a burst of damage, whereas the 4-second stun every 10 seconds comes out at level 4 if he's full strength.
Yeah, but you get the 0.25. Ah, I lay a big mistake here as we rotate the ground on. Kirstez Coplay is coming in to help tight in the mid, and Elliot goes down. What I was saying is it will interrupt the TP though, even with 0.25 seconds.
Yeah, I suppose that is a good point of it, because if they do get in a position where someone's trying to TP away, it does allow them that disruption.
I mean, obviously Rubik can use lift, but if that's on cooldown, they would have a bit of an issue. Well, we're trying to do a little bit of harass here. Timber chain in, but Morphling's already moved. Good attempt, though, I guess, to do a little bit of damage there. It's so difficult to harass Morphling down, though, because, you know, he just morphs stress.
Stop you. Up again.
And this is another
Yeah, stop. That's true, but... I think they're just trying to pull into the lane now and deny them XP, but unfortunately it's not really working at the moment.
No, obviously you want to get those creeps to get the kills as well, which seems to be happening okay actually. He's still not really picking up much from the lane at all.
What they do have to be careful of is the Timbersaw getting his 6 and just taking that stack as soon as he does turn 6.
Yeah, just throw the Whirling Blades in and have at it. Oh, they're going to chase in here. That was a really beautiful combination there. Who did he heal bomb? Did he just heal bomb the Rubik?
Heal bomb himself.
Yeah, lift bomb, lifted up up with a stun and then the heal bomb to follow. That's a problem, obviously, with Timber being so low level. He can't just be taken out with the combo there. A little bit of harass earlier and then combination of it, take him out. The Edelfang
feel...
safely and still managing to find his farm.
Yeah, Viper's got to be really careful here, because if he gets bounced by that Mystic Snake, then he's going to die.
Yeah, Mystic Snake doing 200 damage now, and Elliot on 184 hit points. Yep, we've even
Radiant's
the,
middle tower is under
for,
attack.
Magic resistance. How many points does he have in Corrosive Skin.
Yeah, he has 4 points.
Yeah, so I mean, he probably wouldn't quite die.
Corrosive Skin, he's got 3 points at the moment, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, that gives him an extra 20% magic resistance, giving him 40% overall. So, he probably would survive a Mystic Snake, but I mean, any right click to follow up and he'd be in serious trouble.
It's just with the bounces though, without every bounce it adds more damage, so if he gets hit on the 4th bounce, he'll be hit by 365%, 360 damage rather than 200.
Yeah, the time we were talking about, there was only a catapult in lane though, so I think that's where my math went wrong.
Lone Druid bottom's being dived.
Rotation's so strong from We Kinda Suck.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
New treasures.
Sure, this is a good idea. Oh, but defensive scream use.
Regeneration.
Not able to harass at all. Treads then picked up for Medusa. Having a quick look here at the 8-minute mark, see where people are at with their items. We've got the just a straightforward Basilius on Rene, on Headdress on Aquila on Elliot. So he is going to build into a mech as his first item, I think. Meanwhile,
close,
over on it looks like Paul is going to build an early kind of Voidstone. He's going to build him
Persistence.
Oh yeah, okay. Of course he's going to build that thing. Oh my god.
I think he might be building the, trying to go for the Lincoln Sphere, but I think that's really a bad choice this game. It's just going to slow him down.
Yeah, he could have gone for something a little bit more offensive. Meanwhile, Visage actually picks up the kill on Omni Knight with a nice rotation at the top there. Sorry, that was the fighting bottom that was happening there that we were looking at. I mean, farm-wise, it really is a battle between Aerofang and the two cores on We Kinda Suck. Elliot a little bit behind there, but still doing a decent job, I think, in mid, given the fact that we've only seen him in the position 4, position 5 support roles in the past.
Yeah, he's playing very well. Lone Druid at the moment sitting on 45 last hits, the Morphling's 43, and the Medusa and Viper sitting even on last hits at the moment, so it is... It's even on net worth, I believe, at the moment.
Just
100 gold, sort of 100.
Early. Yeah, on Fin Death, that first kill on Fin Death is what's keeping Morphling ahead there, but not bad, not bad. Fin Death managing to chain out, but here comes Copless, and Elliot's also rotated. That's really good. Yeah, nice. I don't know, do you think they're going to be able to make anything out of this mid lane rotation? Timber chain in onto Copless, there goes the
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Lift, though. Elliot with the Venom Strike on. with the Ravage. Things could be problematic now. Trying desperately to get this kill on Paul, but I think they'd have been better served going for the supports in this situation. Here come the birds, though, and they are going to get Paul. Visage, Rennie on to Visage, just cleaning house here. Elliot picks up Viper as well. A triple kill. That's a great trade, but mid tower is going to be going down.
Radiant structures are fortified. Dyer's
Lone Druid,
bottom
though,
tower
takes bottom tower in return, so
Radiant's
overall
middle tower
a fairly
fallen.
Decent trade, I think, for generic Dota team. Text.
Yeah, definitely. The only trick I think they missed was they didn't decide to continue to push and take that tier 1 tower top. I know a couple of them were low, but I believe they could have done that no problems. I think they were just a wee bit scared, worrying that they would all respawn and TP back in immediately.
It is a shame, because obviously Elliot almost has that mech finish, so... I think that would have kind of helped their overall push, but meanwhile, the Lone Druid has rotated round. He looks like he's going to go and just kind of aim for tier 1s now. I think he's probably going to head mid, actually.
Invisibility!
I think he is going to go mid.
I would like to see that Medusa get her level 10 point. Well, obviously she's going to get her level 10 point in that split shot and go top and take that stack. I just feel that there should have been a little bit more time spent stacking for her, so the Rubick could sit beside her and sap the XP.
Yeah, there is only that one set of stacks as well, and obviously with the rotations from the support, so many rotations from the support, that's kind of the trade-off there.
Tyree playing Medusa, that was sort of their saving grace at the moment after that poor trade up top, where they had four heroes versus three, but ended up having turned round. Even with the use of Ravage, they were just too busy focusing down different heroes rather than focusing down the one which spread their damage too thin.
Maybe a little bit of underestimation of the pure damage coming out on Thin Death, and certainly that rotation from Visage definitely caught them off guard, able to pick off Paul and use the thing. The Visage
Radiant's
thing
bottom
the damage,
tower is under attack.
To nuke down.
But that engagement definitely helped Finn Death out, because he's sitting with his arcane boots and 1300 gold in the bank, which is putting him a lot closer to his Bloodstone than he was sitting at the 45 minute mark.
Odru takes the mid tower as well, pretty much for free. These guys are going to push in top, are going to try and push in top, and Generic desperately kind of try to zone them out and keep them at bay there. It's working so far.
I think we're going to see an early Radiance coming out on the Lone Druid as well. He's sitting at 3,000 gold at the moment, which is extremely good considering he's got phase boots and boots at the moment. I think we're going to see about a 17 minute Radiance, and it's going to be extremely early and really vital for their push.
Focusing on, I mean, the combination of the Visage as well obviously allows, and I guess to an extent the Viper obviously allows them to do a fair bit of pushing there, but they have picked up all these stacks now.
Purification!
And, not really helping out. Lone Druid's still leading the farm charts there. I'd like to see a rotation from Lone Druid at some point to the top if these guys are going to struggle to do anything there.
I don't feel they should be fighting at the moment.
The mech on the screen, the boulder's gonna go down as well, and Paul's gonna rush in here, and Elliot's gonna
go. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I guess the Lone Druid takes the tier 2 and responds to that.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I'd hope so. I feel like Generic Dota team forced the issue there, having their four heroes sat at the top. I feel they should have backed off, maybe farmed the jungle, pushed other lanes.
Yeah, I think basically.
Because all that's happened now is they've been able to take that fight, win the fight with their five heroes, TP bottom, and push away the Lone Druid.
Assumption, early soul assumption from Rennie there, and another one to follow up though, max level almost. Not a great lich ult there, just positioning wise, nothing to slow down the, I'd really like to see Timbersaw working with the lich a little bit more there, just in regards to popping that ult, keeping them all kind of a little bit smooth so that you get more bounces.
Yeah, I'd like to see this Timbersaw pick up a Blink Dagger before his Bloodstone. Just for the maneuverability that it's going to offer.
Well, he has finished up the Soul Ring here, so he may pause and pick up some other items before finishing up the Bloodstone.
Even a Blade Mail would be really good on him at the moment, just due to the amount of burst that the other team have got. He's not able to pick up those reactive armor points.
Oh, this picked up by the Timbersaw, and it looks like they're going to head top with that. Could catch Paul out here. Oh, there is a double stack of ancients now as well.
I do like the Medusa's build though, because she has went for the more team fight build. Although it's not the all in the team fight build, but she has got her early Yasha, and now she's making her way towards her Skadi. And sort of once she has her Skadi. It's almost a bit too much for a Generic Dota team to contest with, to be honest.
How is Lone Druid going on his quest for the Radiance?
He's got his sacred relic now.
Radiance bottom tower is under attack.
Another item there as well. Looks like he might be thinking about locking the bear up a bit.
Yeah, there's also a vitality booster on the courier for it. Yeah.
He's gonna go for the bloodstone early.
Yeah. I would like to see generic Dota team 5-man pushing though, or 4-man pushing with the lone druid on his own, trying to take those towers. I feel he's missing a trick though, not pulping his ult and getting that extra. I think it's 90 damage at level 2 with the active ability that it grants for him and his bear. So that's an extra 180 damage that he's sort of missing out on at the moment.
Yeah, I think generic just a little bit wary, obviously, with the failure that they had at the top lane there. It's kind of flooded their confidence a little bit. There goes Cockles. This is just going to get out, I think. Oh, Bear gets a Italian. Here comes the Scream. That's going to be a big problem for generic. There goes Timber. There goes Visage. There goes Lich. The ult is still bouncing, but they're going to have to back here. And that's not gonna do their confidence any good at all, I don't think. Basically a nice rotation from we kinda suck. 5-man there. But I mean obviously if Lone Druid was in another lane right now, that there would be towers falling and maybe that is an issue.
Yeah, that tier one definitely would have fell top if he had decided to split push rather than sit with his team. But it's a decision we kind of have to make, whether or not to play as a 5-man unit or do that split push. But obviously with the pressure of we kind of suck with their 5-man, I think they're feeling a bit obligated to 5-man themselves.
The only thing is, I think the 5-man kind of suck is a little bit stronger.
Yeah, it definitely is. And the only problem is with generic Dota team is they don't have that late game carry.
Oh,
I've noticed that from
he does get blown up in the end. Paul though picks off Viper on the backside of that, and they're trying so desperately to try to pick him up here as well. But Tidy
Radiant's
is here, Kirstus is here, Errol Klang is going to go down. That's a huge blow for generic, but there is a full soul assumption already here. That is going to cost them. They need to focus down other targets. Morphling is too strong.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
With what they've got in their arsenal at the moment.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
It's difficult though. You just leave the Morphling alone.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
He's going to do some serious damage.
Yeah. I think Lich has made a bit of a mistake with his skill build, deciding not to put any points in ice armor yet. That would really be helping out his team if he'd had that maybe at two or three points, next 5 to 7 armor.
Exactly. Just obviously as well, I'll let some pop on the tower and makes these tower pushes so much harder. Helping Rennie out a little bit with the harass. Overall, on the bear as well, it's pretty fearsome. Full soul assumption then going to be coming up onto Rennie here. We'll see whether or not he's able to get it before it goes down.
I do feel Errol Klang should definitely be in his ultimate state at the moment because it's an extra 600 health, so he'd be sitting at 1500, almost 1600 health at the moment. Making him a lot tankier and a lot harder to take down, and it also gives him that access to that extra damage and attack speed.
I'm not sure why he's not. I think he just wants to be able to be at range. I don't really agree with that, but I don't know. He must have the Radiant system.
I don't think he's... he's just 200 gold off now. I do think he's a little... He's not as confident with his macro, I think, as he should be playing a lone druid. I think that's maybe why he hasn't decided to go bear form. I don't think he can keep the distance from the bear as much, being in bear form as he can when he's playing ranged.
Yeah. Also, this ward here... they have got a sentry down now, that's fair enough. Really, always really good warding on We Kinda Suck, I have to say. Sentry's always placed along with Obs wards, just so they can see well, in the places where there's likely to be wards from the enemy.
Yeah, that's true. I like their position of their sentry wards because it's covering two of the most popular spots for a warden, rather than just sticking both the wards on the same one spot, therefore missing out the other ward.
Wouldn't have got my favourite ward spot here though. Wouldn't have picked that one up.
Yeah, that is good as well.
I do like it. It gives high ground vision of the area across the river as well. It's really nice.
Well, I quite like doing it. Minute one is at the bottom rune, the rune spot just above it, and it's got the trees that you can now, the rune spot you can now walk to, getting a quelling blade and chopping them all down, so you have the vision of your jungle as well.
Yeah, yeah, but it's kind of obvious you've got a ward there then. People are like, hey, those trees are gone. But I mean, obviously with the timber around, I do like to have a quelling blade anyway, and I'll just chop away any kind of trees in my lane at all. I don't really like to get timber chained, it's not fun.
That's the Skadi up on the Medusa. I think she's had it for about 2 or 3 minutes now. 20, I think she'll probably be going for the Manta now.
Yeah, Findeath almost finished up his Bloodstone. Like I say, that death on Erofang really put the Radiance back. Meaning he's not going to pick it up now until about 25
minutes.
That
is Lone Druid with his Radiance now.
Yeah, he's got it now. There we go. 24 minutes just about Radiance there. But let's look at the items on the Dire team. We got Mech Arcanes on Coplis with Full Bond. Oh, Big Smoke here. I'm going to get back to that in a second. Let's have a look and see where these guys go. I'm just going to wrap around. They're probably going to find a Massager or Fang combo here, and that's going to be problematic. Oh, they spotted it out with the birds, did they?
Invisibility!
Yeah, they're going to head for
Rosh. I think they're deciding whether or not they're doing Rosh.
I mean, no wards for...
Because they could easily do Rosh with that Titan Hunter.
Oh, well, with the Medusa as well. I mean, she's going to have decent damage. Any kind of amulet or anything of courage on their side? Nah.
I definitely think an Ags pick up on Lone Druid would be perfect for this game if he wants to have that ability to 5-man push, 5-man with his team as well as pushing. Because he could be with his team while his bear pushes and then recall him back for any team fights that do occur.
Yeah, I think they definitely need the bear for the team fight. They don't really have much lockdown. Slow, obviously. Oh, we've got some frost armor now, though, which might help things out a little bit. We're all here in mid, so Mystic Snake's galore. Oh, and here comes Greff with the Ravage, and boom, the heal bomb to follow up as well.
Lone Druid's just completely backed himself up. He should have had his bear scaring them all away and doing that Radiance back down.
Almost gets picked off. Kirstez in a little bit of trouble here, but Greff charging in deep here. Findeath gets taken out by the Anchor Smash, and Greff just gonna blink out. Meanwhile, Morphling picks up Aerofang on the Lone Druid. Bit of a disaster for
Radiant's
Genetic
middle
there.
Tower
kind
is
of
under attack.
Under the pressure, under
Radiant
the
structures are fortified.
Of, we kind of suck.
Yeah, Medusa is one of those heroes that a lot of people don't think about, but she does fit into this early death ball pushing strat that people love to do this patch.
I mean, items-wise, she is ready to rock and roll. Anything she picks up from now is just going to be a bonus.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
If she'd gone for the same build that Paul's gone for, I feel like the game could be in a bit of a different position, because that Lincoln Sphere really offers no real advantage on either hero in this game, apart from the Viper ult, to be honest.
Yeah, as I said, no real lockdown on the team, Generic team. Obviously, they have the Bear and Tangle. They have the slow on Viper. Timbersaw's chain is obviously AoE slow though. The birds are AoE stun. I guess the ult from Lich, but I mean, so long as you're on your own, that's not really a factor. The only one point in ice armor at this point as well.
Yeah, they do have a lot of slow, but they don't have any stun. What I think really would have helped them out in this sort of game would be sort of a Magnus to catch a couple of heroes out in RP, pull them back away from the rest of the team, quickly pick them off, and then all of a sudden their push is gone. You don't need to wipe the whole team for that to disadvantage the team.
Yeah, maybe a little bit of fear on the rappel, but I mean, it's not going to save them from a Magnus. We got a Manta finished up on Paul now as well. That's going to severely improve their push ability. Obviously, he can split.
The Tide Hunter's only 1700 gold off his refresher orb already, which is going to make these team fights even easier for We Kinda Suck. But they're definitely proving in this game that they don't kind of suck, because they're showing a dominant game here, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, definitely the second strongest team in the group. I mean, obviously that argument has already been settled. Team Straight were able to take them 2-0. But yeah, I mean, these guys are no slouches, despite what they were saying in the lobby beforehand. Obviously, my prediction for this would be a 2-0 for We Kinda Suck. I mean, I'm really impressed by Generic in this game, though.
Roshan has fallen to the early game.
It's a shame they weren't able to follow up, but what they were able to hold them off and actually kind of put quite a bit of pressure on there. And obviously that's with people being in different roles from what we've seen them in all four games they've previously played. I mean, they're not winning this game. They're 15k down in gold and XP, 16k gold wise, in fact it's maybe a bit more than that. But yeah, I mean, they're not winning it, but I'm certainly impressed with the shake-up of their lanes there. Unfortunately, the smoke not going to find anything. I mean, this top tower should have been gone a long time ago. So much space has been available for them to operate with. And just kind of taking the team fights that maybe they weren't quite ready to take. If that bear had got his Radiance at 17 minutes, which he was on course to get, I think maybe they would have been...
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Been able to do a lot more damage before the Medusa picked up.
He's finally popped his ult. we've got a 29 minute lone druid ult.
Hey guys, this gives me more HPs and damages.
But it's actually, I was wrong, it's actually 240 extra damage that lone druid and his bear would get between them.
A bit of a wipe here, I think, for Genetic. Paul just charging in. Fear with the Morphling there. Going to create all the space they need to try and push this tower in here. Litz, though, manages to pick up the Tidehunter on the back of that fight with Al. Paul now might be in a little bit of trouble. He does go down, obviously. He does have the Aegis. He is coming back. But yeah, I mean, worth blowing the Aegis to try and do that damage onto
Radiant's bottom
tower
is under attack.
Well, it depends if they take it or not. They could actually hold here. I think that dive was unnecessary. They've actually been pushed off. They've actually managed to hold.
Yeah, I mean, this is something that we saw against Team Straight as well, and a few other times where just a little bit too much confidence, a little bit too much aggression, over aggression shown by We Kinda Suck, and kind of cost them there a little bit. The Tidehunter went down, they burst the Aegis, and the tower, as you say, is still firmly in place.
I think the Medusa might be picking up an MKB or a Daedalus at the moment. I think an MKB makes a lot more sense than a Daedalus, just for the multi-shot, the split shot, and just applies a bit more damage than the Daedalus will.
I mean, it will give her ability to fight uphill, I guess, a bit more as well.
Yeah, it means that she can stand back in the fight, so on the low ground, and not take that front row position. She can let her Tidehunter do that, and her Morphling, who can survive pretty much anything that Generic Dota team can throw at her at the moment.
Yeah, that's been shown quite a few times now, and generic, like I say, over focusing the Morphling, but I mean, with no real stuns, I don't think it's, I mean, even if they do stun him, he can still morph the strength, obviously.
That's a missed kill there from Lone Druid.
Yeah,
rather than attacking the solo Rubik, he ran away. You can see that their confidence has been knocked in this game.
It is a real shame after that early start there. Let's have a little look and see how the levels are going at the moment. Level 18 on Morph, level 17 on Medusa, level 15 on Gref on the offlane Tidehunter, and then we find the Lone Druid on level 14. Yeah, so I mean, obviously, they are getting a lot more out of the map because the generic are well pushed in here. I mean, they can pretty much farm anywhere they want, but they're kind of sticking to the 5-man push. Well, to an extent, we start farming up the back there. Gref taking some more ancients. Obviously, as well, with those ancient stacks that were available for Gref, that kind of gave him a little bit of a boost as well. And it does look like it is going to be an MKB on the Medusa there. Did you notice there was a javelin coming?
And we've also got the refresher orb coming up for the Tidehunter and the Courier. So that'll really help them pierce this high ground and probably win this next fight, as we don't have buyback status on any of their heroes at the moment. Oh, we've got buyback status on all their heroes, sorry, apart from the Lone Druid and the Viper.
So that you know the important ones.
Yeah. Well, that Timbersaw is pushing out a lot of damage at the moment. I definitely think with 2.4k gold, they should be picking up a blade mail to try and take some of this damage and reflect it back to them.
Gref with the refresher and the double ult, followed up by the Guardian Angel, and you're just going to see a bit of an explosion here. Thunder's in a little bit of trouble, but a heal bomb on the system. Lich does buy back. Visage does buy back. Maybe they can very well just back at this point and take
Radiant's
that. They're going to finish up the racks.
Under attack.
And not too showing any real concern here. There is a full soul assumption on Rene, though. He could do a little bit of damage here.
They're bloodthirsty. They want more. They want it all. They're going to dive them into that fountain if they have to. They're taking everything here.
Yeah, they're gonna finish up here. We will probably see a GG fairly soon from generic. A few of their heroes will have to go down first, but I'm seeing it's gonna happen. Oh, that's a mistake. Why is he even in that area? He should be up here on that next tower if he does want to stick around. And the Lone Druid managing to pick off Paul there for a huge amount of gold. Big swing. It's actually still in the favor of We Kinda Suck. But XP-wise, they did get 3k XP out of that, so yeah, I mean, they're going to be happy with that, I think.
To be honest, that in net worth time terms, that kill really did nothing at all with the amount of gold they got for taking that rax. It sort of made it equal.
Actually, it was We Kinda Suck actually took 800 gold overall, I think, and 665.
Regeneration.
For generic, just with the guys that went down there. But I mean, 1,237 gold for the Viper. I wonder what he's going to do with it. Maybe finish up his axe?
Well, he just finished up his axe just now. And we've got a Maelstrom come out on the Lone Druid as well. To help. I think they won't try and hold this against Mega Creeps if it comes down to it. But obviously, they need to try and put a bit more push in at the moment.
Well, we did see both I think of the longest games in the tournament so far being played out by generic. One of them I think went for about 45 minutes, and the other one was a grueling 64 minutes till long into the wee hours of the night. Rene trying so desperately hard to win that one for them on the Beastmaster, but yeah, that was an impressively long game. Of Dota, they managed to hold off for an awful long time.
So we've got 4k now up on the Timbersaw. I think he should really sell his point booster and his vitality booster and even his soul ring, and maybe try and invest all the gold into a scythe to try and shut down that Medusa, give them that stun, just that ability to sort of control it. And he does pick up a Mystic Staff, so I'm wondering if this could be the be an Octarine Core coming out instead, and I think it is.
Yeah, it could definitely be an Octarine. There is the Octarine Core. Okay, so that's going to bring his cooldowns down, and it's going to make him a bit of a beast, actually, because obviously he is going to heal out of all of that. I quite like the Scythe pickup, though. If he'd have gone for that, it'd have been okay. There's no Lincoln Sphere, obviously, on Tyree, choosing to go the other way there, but Paul just picked up a Butterfly. Have a quick look at the items here. So Octarine finish for Finn Death, that could be interesting. Elliot, it looks like, might be building a Deso or a Maelstrom for Maelstrom for the oh Jesus, where did that happen? Where was that? Top? Bottom. Did you just catch someone out here? Paul on his own here at Bombay probably has a... No, he doesn't even have a remnant there. He's just not showing much respect for the potential of Generic to pick him off here.
I'm just wondering whether this Morphling's going to go for an E-Blade. More of a shotgun build as well with that Butterfly. Huge amounts of burst damage coming out. Or he'll go for, I don't know, a Skadi. Go for a bit more tankiness so he can full morph his agility.
What do we think Coplus is going to build then, now that he has GG boots and an ultimate orb? Crit stick also picked up on Tyree there, baby crit stick.
Roshan has fallen to the immortality.
I think we might actually see a Skadi coming out for the Omni Knight, but in more realistic terms, it's probably going to be that Scythe.
Yeah, I mean, farm-wise though, I'm not sure he's going to get it. They do have the Aegis now, and they are going to need to take another set of racks on the back of that, I would expect. And if they do take that one set of racks, they're probably going to be able to finish up.
I would have liked to have seen a Lotus Orb come out this game on the Omni Knight. Just put on that Medusa and let her go in and take everything and have it all reflected back.
Well, obviously she does have the scream if things go wrong. Okay, here we go then. Big push at the top racks here. The bear coming in. Immediately running out again. Gref gonna pop the
Radiant
Strike. For objectives here, realizing of course that we don't really want to miss
out. Radiant's top tower.
There goes the screen though, and followed up by the
Radiant's
second Ravage. Going to start seeing heroes going down now. There goes Zag. There goes Timbersaw. Ult from Lich onto Paul. Paul in so deep again, and Elliot, be careful. And Timbersaw just trying to do a little bit of pure damage there, but it's not going to be enough. Their Viper goes down to the combined teamfight efforts. Rubick picking up the kill, and here comes that cheeky Lich out from the Rubick. That's pretty
not quite kill anyone.
Almost though, almost. The racks go down. They're going to be able to wrap around and take this racks as well. I'm pretty sure they're going to call GG. Yeah,
that's GG. Yeah.
So we kind of suck. Take game one. Quite the battle that we saw before, but 41 minutes.
We actually had a flawless game. We actually had a flawless game from Medusa not dying once in that game.
Oh yeah, definitely. Giving them a kill death assist ratio of 22-1. Not too shabby on Tyree's Medusa there. Well, that was game one, guys. Join us in about 5 minutes for game two and see whether or not We Kinda Suck can make it 2-0 and whether or not Generic are going to be able to field anything there to blunt that.